for this specific term, that is management.
या मैम,
So can you tell us something about this?
मैनेजमेंट मीन्स गेटिंग वर्क डन फ्रॉम अदर्स
हम्म,
एंड प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट, आई थिंक 14 प्रिंसिपल ऑफ मैनेजमेंट आर देयर.
वेरी गुड, वेरी गुड. So when we are saying that management means getting work done through others, so how we are getting work done through others? We are going to use, I mean, we are going to scold them, we are going to threaten them, or are we going to motivate them? What do you think that what is the best possible method?
We are going to motivate them. Hmm. I think, yeah.
Okay, let's suppose you are the manager of a firm and there are few employees in your organization. So are you going to use a same method to motivate all the employees, or are you going to use the different methods to motivate your employees?
Ma'am, different methods to motivate different employees.
Why?
Ma'am, all the employees are not same.
Hmm.
Employees differ from their background or their job.
Hmm.
That's why
you will use the different methods to motivate the employees.
Yes, yes.
Okay, very good, very good. So today I'm going to show you one presentation. Just let me present my screen. Are you able to see my screen?
No, ma'am.
Okay, wait. Still you are not able to see my screen?
No, ma'am.
Okay, let
me... Ma'am, it is showing that you are presenting, but the presentation is not visible.
Okay, sir. Still it is creating problem like that day. Just give me a few minutes. Sir, now are you able to see my screen?
Ma'am, it is showing that you are presenting to everyone.
But it is not showing slides.
Yeah, which browser you are using, ma'am?
That is Google Chrome, sir.
Okay, so it must show it. Have you given permission to show your screen or everything?
Yes, sir. I have already given permission. Last time this also happens and.
It is working right now. Let's see.
Let's wait for some time if it gets open.
Ma'am, open this presentation.
This presentation, sir?
Yes, open it. Now it is working, ma'am.
It's working. Are you able to see it, sir?
Yeah. Go on to the slideshow.
Okay, sir.
Sneha, you are able to see it, beta?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay.
Are you able to see it?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. Thank you so much, sir. And thank you, Sneha. for your patient. So now we'll discuss about management. As we are, the flow of presentation would be like that, that first we will discuss about definition, then we will discuss about concept, and in the last we will discuss nature of management.
Okay, ma'am.
Now, first of all, what is the definition of management? As you already told me that you have already know about the 14 principles of management. So I'm sure you know about F.W. Taylor.
Yes, ma'am.
He is, or he, what we used to refer him.
He is the father of management.
He is a father of scientific management.
Scientific management, yeah.
Yes. So according to F.W. Taylor, management is an art of knowing what is to be done and seeing that it is done in the best possible manner. So in this definition, you can see the two components. The first component is what is to be done. And the second component is that it is to be done in the best possible manner.
Manner.
Right. So from these two terms, we can understand that one term is indicating on the efficiency and the other term is indicating on effectiveness.
Yes, ma'am.
So do you know the difference between the efficiency and effectiveness?
Yes, ma'am. Effectiveness, yes, means on time, and efficiency means using less cost for the best quality.
Yes,
less resource.
Very good, very good. See, efficiency means when you are using the less resources, when you are minimizing the cost, when you are not wasting resources, and by decreasing the cost of production, or by decreasing the time, by minimizing the time, whatever you are producing, that is efficiency. On the other hand, is the effectiveness, it focuses on the end results, that whatever we want to achieve, whether we have achieved that or not. Let's suppose there is a situation, there are two managers and you are the client, fine. And the two managers, and you gave them some proposal that, okay, fine, because I have given you some project and you have to give me some draft or proposal for this specific project. They both have prepared some project. The first manager, what they have done, they haven't gone through the deep marketing research, but they have completed that work on time and they have placed that proposal on your table within that deadline, okay? And there's a second manager, what they have done, they have taken 1 week extra, and they, if within that 1 week, what they have asked you to give them a 1 week extra, they have done the deep marketing research, and after doing that deep marketing research, they have placed that report on your table. So there are two reports on your table and you are the client. You have to decide that whom you are going to give that project. Now, as per your, as per your discretion or as per your logic, you will give project to whom you will prefer to give that project and why?
Ma'am, to the second one, because he researched deeply. So in future, when he work on that project, so we will be easily can do the project because he knows all about that project because he deeply researched. And I don't give to the first one because he don't researched deeply.
Perfect reply. Very good, Sneha. See, the reason is that always in the management, it is always preferred that we should have the optimum utilization of resources. We should have the minimum wastage of resources because we have limited resources like land, labor, and capital. These are the factors of production. And we should have the minimum wastage of these resources, but not at the cost of end result. Because whatever we want to achieve, if we are not able to achieve it, then there is no meaning that we are just focusing on the cost. That, okay, fine, we have completed our project on the time. But at what cost? We have not achieved our result. Fine, are you getting me?
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay, very good. Now, these are the concept of management. So basically, managing the 5 M's of an organization, that is the most important preference for an manager or for any firm, or this is the this is the foundation on which management work, that we have to manage the 5 M's of an organization. Now let's see what are these 5 M's. These are men, material, money, machinery, method. Very good. You can also speak. It's very good. See, the first one is men.
Yeah.
The men means the labor force, the manpower, the workforce, which is working in your organization. See, this manpower or this workforce is really an asset of your organization. Your capital, your advanced technology, your amicable infrastructure, or whatever you have, they are assets, but these are nothing in front of your manpower. You might have very luxurious, so many advanced technology, or you might have amicable facilities in your organization, but if your manpower is not up to the mark, it means your organization cannot sustain in any competitive environment. See, here I would like to give one example. You know about IBM and Microsoft?
Yeah.
Okay. See, there are two these two organizations, like in the in 1990, IBM was a leading organization, and this Microsoft was not up to that level, up to the level of IBM in terms of profit, in terms of sales. So IBM was like, they are focusing more on profit, but it's still at that time when IBM was leading the market in terms of market share, in terms of growth. Still, Microsoft was not at all bothered about these things. And what they have done, they were still focusing on their employees. They were still focusing on their organizational culture, because they knew very well that if we have to sustain in a long run, and if we want to earn a profit in the long run, we have to forget about the short-term profits, because these are our real assets. These human beings, these employees are real assets, because if they are satisfied, sooner or later, we will be able to tap those market which we have not tapped yet now, or we can turn this loss into a profit. So the most important thing is that they are continuously working on the welfare of the employees, and they still work. They were working on the building the organizational culture. After some time, the result was that, and still it is in front of you, that Microsoft is the leading company, then IBM. So what I am trying to say, that your manpower, they should be satisfied. They should be motivated. If your labor, if your workforce, if your employees, they are not at all satisfied, that however advanced technology you have, it is not going to serve your purpose, because these advanced technology are still to be operated by any human being. You're getting me? See, yeah. Basically, because you know, in the when you told me that you have gone through this subject management, so you might be aware there are 3 levels of management. That is, yeah, the lower level, middle level, and upper level. Yes. So if you say that, okay, fine, ma'am, I can do one thing, that I can replace this lower level. Okay, fine, I agree that you can place some automated technology in place of that unskilled labor. Fine. But what about that middle level or top level? How can any technology can make any strategic decision? Can it?
No, ma'am.
No, because there is no such technology which can take the strategic decision, which can do the competitor analysis, which can do the pestle analysis. For this, again, you need the human being. Again, you need the managers of your organization. So what I'm trying to say is that being a good manager, the most important thing is that you have to satisfy your manpower. I know it's very difficult to satisfy all the human beings, but that's the duty of an organization, that if they have to sustain in this competitive era, they have to motivate their employee. They have to work on their welfare. They should not exploit their employees. there should not be such policies that employees should feel uncomfortable. They are looking, okay, fine, they are using your net and they are searching for job from for another company. It means they are not loyal towards the organization. The first thing the best HR manager can do is that they should make their employees loyal and committed towards an organization. And if you have failed to make them committed to your organization, then believe me, sooner or later you have to bear the consequences of that. Are you getting me, beta?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The next one is material. We all know very well, material, it means the raw material. Like if it is a production company, obviously it needs some raw material, then only they can transform that raw material into some output, that is product. Like if there is a car manufacturing company, they might be requiring that steel, that raw steel, so that they can transform into it into an output, that is like a car. That is the material. So basically what we are doing, that the material should be of quality. The material should have that quality. We are not going to cheat our customers, because for any organization to survive in this competitive era, the two things should be keep in mind. First is your employee and second is your customer. Many times, I'm sorry to say that, but in context of Indian organizations, number of researches have been done in this context. What we used to do, that we mostly focus on the customer. That okay, fine, my customer should be happy. I agree. It is the most important thing that your organization will survive because of these customers. But if you are neglecting your employees, who are your internal customers, then believe me, you are not going to satisfy your customer also, because they are the representative of your company. They are going to represent your company. So first you have to satisfy your internal customers, then only you can satisfy your external customers. But in context of India, number of times it happens, I'm not saying in almost all the organization, but in some organization, that we are focusing more on the customers. We are emphasizing more on the customers. Whatever we are selling, whatever we are producing, whatever we are offering, that should be from the customer's perspective. No, it should not be like that. You have to first satisfy your employee, and eventually they will tap your customers. That they will tap those customers who have not been tapped by your competitors. The next one is money. We all know about it. That is the capital. For any organization, when you have to start any organization, or when you have to expand your business, when you have to go for diversification of your business, you need money. Because without money, you cannot run your business. Because that's why we used to say that finance is the blood of an organization. Are you there, Sneha?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now, the next is machinery. Machinery, those tools or those equipments which are going to transform those inputs into an output. Those equipments or those tools which you are using to transform that raw material into an output. These are machineries and the method. The method which you are using to transforming these inputs into an output. What sort of method you are using? So these are 5 M's of an organization. Is there any question related to these 5 M's?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Shall I move to the next slide?
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Now let's discuss about the traditional concept and the modern concept of management. See, earlier, according to this traditional concept, what we used to prefer, that the management or the role of manager is like that they have to delegate the task. They have to simply give the orders. There should be a hierarchical organization, and you cannot bypass any channel. So let's suppose if you are an employee of an organization, and if you have any complaint related to your peer or related to your manager, then you have to follow the channel, then you have to follow the hierarchy. So let's suppose if you have to complain against your manager, then first you will present your complaint in front of your manager that okay, fine, I'm going to complain against you and this is my complaint. So like this is the hierarchical organization, whatever. If you have to take any approval, again you have to follow this hierarchy from your supervisor, then again to your manager, then again it will move to the top management. But don't you think if we are going to follow this hierarchical organization, unnecessary, it will waste our time?
Yeah, ma'am, because we can't directly pass the information if it's emergency or anything.
Of course, definitely, very perfect answer. That see, if there's any emergency, if the situation is like that, we cannot pass the information because I don't have any approval from my manager. I cannot pass it to the lower level of employees. I need approval from the top management, from the lower management. Then only I will pass that information to the lower level of employees. But if you are building this, according to this traditional concept, there was a hierarchical of organization. And this hierarchical of organization, it gives birth to the bureaucratic system. You know, in the bureaucracy, there is a lot of corruption. There's a lot of politics involved and there is a bureaucracy. Because every time if you need some approval, either you have to, lick their feet or you have to bribe them. In most of the bureaucracy, it is there. Because you cannot take approval so easily. I know that government is changing their method. They are making many things very transparent. But in earlier days, it was like that. If I need some approval, every time I have to pay some bribe. Now, this is the drawback of the hierarchical system of organization. And what about the decision making? The decision would be taken by the central authority. Nobody else is supposed to take any decision. So either you are on my way or you are fired. Either you have to follow me or you are fired from my organization. So in any case, you are not supposed to say anything. You have to follow my order. You have to abide by all the decisions which are taken by me. What were the consequences? Can you imagine the consequences if the manager who is sitting in that place and if he or she is not so competent and if they are asking you to do some that task which is not feasible for you and you cannot say, you cannot utter a word against that person, what would be your situation? Would you be loyal to that organization?
No, ma'am.
Because, sooner or later...
I can't express my thoughts there, so I can't be loyal there.
Perfect. Because if you are not able to express your thought, if you are not able to express your feelings, then your grievances would be piled up. And sooner or later, you will find an opportunity that the moment I will get the best job, I would leave this organization. See, in most of the cases, number of researchers have published their research and they have said that the employees doesn't leave their organization because organization is not providing them that opportunity or organization is not providing them that facility, but they are leaving the organization because of their managers. So you can you can think about the difference that the employee is not frustrated from the organization, but employees are frustrated from their managers. That's why they are leaving the organization. And see, it is very easy to replace the unskilled workforce. Okay, fine. We will find ample number of unskilled workforce. But if you are losing a good employee, then it would be very difficult to replace that employee. And you can say, okay, ma'am, in India, there are a number of unemployed employees. I can replace them easily. I agree, you can. But is it possible that he can take up the charge immediately? Whatever your previous employee was doing, because he was aware, okay, fine, I have to handle this project in this way. These are my clients. But if he or she leave your organization and you have hired some other employee, he or she will take time to understand about all those things, all aspects related to that project. Apart from that, he will take time in maintaining the compatibility amongst the peers. It is not so easy that it will come instantly. So the first and the foremost thing is that the manager should be good. They should not be like have the attitude of exploiting their managers. So they should treat their employees as a family member. They should delegate the task on the basis of their skills, on the basis of their capability. So right now we have somewhere you might have noticed this definition of management, that the first and foremost thing is that the right men at the right place at the right time.
Right time.
Why we are emphasizing that right men? Right men? You were saying something, Sneha?
No.
See, nowadays we have changed this definition, and when we just go deep into the HR, or if we are not going deep into the HR, still you have noticed this definition somewhere, you have read it somewhere. Nowadays, that is a concept that the right people at the right place at the right time. Why it is that what we are emphasizing, that the right people should be at the right place? If we are doing the skill matching, that this is the job and this job requires this type of skill, so this person should join this job. There should be a proper alignment between the job and the people who is performing that job, or the people who is performing that task. Because if there is no proper alignment, if we are not doing the matching, or if there is a mismatching, again you have to suffer, or your operation will struggle a lot. So that is the traditional concept. Now let's come to the modern concept. In the modern concept, we are focusing more on the flexible organization. It means, it's a very stupidity that you have to go to the hierarchical way. I mean, we are rather of following the vertical type of organization, we are focusing more on the horizontal type of organization. And what we are doing? Yes, that all the employees, irrespective of their levels, they all are at the same level. They all are at the same level. So anybody can approach anywhere at any time. What is the result of having this horizontal type of organization? I mean, what is the advantage if I'm having a horizontal type of organization instead of vertical type of organization?
Everyone can participate.
Yes, everybody can participate. Everybody can share their ideas.
Yeah.
Yes, perfect. See, bilkul. And your graveyards, they would not be piled up. See, number of organizations, they are also having that open door policy, or they used to have that lockbox, that letterbox type of a system, in which without mentioning your name, you can post your grievances related to any management employee, or related to your manager, or related to your peers, so that organization can investigate into the matter, that if that complaint which you have made, that is factual or that is imaginary. I mean, are you perceiving it that it is a grievance or it is really a problem? So what they are doing, they are treating their employees as an assets. That's why the Narayan Murthy, they used to say that your employees daily in the evening time, they used to leave your organization and make sure that you should treat them in a way that next day they should come to your organization, because they are your assets of an organization. Neither your technology, neither your amicable facilities, neither your land or whatever building or your infrastructure, that is not your asset, because without human being, you cannot run any organization. Is it possible to run any organization without human being, without your manpower?
No, ma'am. Because manpower is needed to work in an organization.
Yes, because a situation can be like that. Okay, fine. I'm having a small setup of an organization. I don't need 500 employees. But still, I need 5 employees to run or to handle these operations. Still, I need the manpower. The number can be different, but we need manpower so that organization can run. So what we are doing? First, we are having the flexible approach in the modern concept of organization. In the same way, the decision making, as you have said earlier, that like it should be the participative decision making. instead of the centralized decision making, we are having the participative decision making. We are asking everybody, okay, fine, you should give your ideas, you should give your thoughts, you should give your views, so that everybody should feel, okay, fine, my ideas are also respected, my ideas are also considered. So you are giving them chance, and by giving them these chances, you are building a harmonious relations between your employees. Because if I'm a teacher and if I'm giving you an assignment and daily I'm coming to your class and without asking anything, at the end of the class I'm giving you an assignment, okay, fine, you would complete that assignment, okay, fine, because if I'm not going to complete my assignment, might be in the second class ma'am will punish me. But because of that harmonious relation between the faculty and the student will not develop. Maybe sooner or later you will not like that subject, you will feel, okay, fine, ma'am aati hai bas padhati hai assignment deke chali jati hai. The other way can be like, if I'm asking you people, okay, fine, if you don't want to do this written assignment, tell me what else you want that you can do. Might be you can say, okay, fine, ma'am, I want to give the presentation. Some might can say, okay, fine, I want to take some project. What is that? I'm asking you people, you just give your suggestion. And what will be the result of this? The result would be that it build a relationship between the teacher and a student. Fine. See, if that link or if that bond is missing between the faculty and the student, again, it will be vain. It will of no use. Apart from that, managers should not be like that every time they are delegating orders. Managers should be like that. They should lead by example. Pehle aap karo, phir dusro ko kaho ki aap kijiye. The manager should be like that. They should lead by example. Hamesha example se lead kare. Jaise hamesha hum kehte hain organization ke andar, every time we have heard or we have read it somewhere that before becoming a manager, you should become a leader. Aap leader baniye. Aap manager mat baniye. Aap leader baniye. So what is the difference between a leader and a manager? See, the manager, what they used to do, they always involved, I mean, maximum of the managers, they always involved in the politics. Whatever there is a good thing, they always take the credit of that. And whatever, if there is a failure of any project, if there is a failure of any task, okay, fine, these employees, this team is responsible. On the contrary, the leader is like that, they always stand ahead if there is a failure of project. Okay, fine, I'm responsible for the failure of this project. My team is not responsible. But if anybody is appreciating for the success, they will ask their team to come ahead. They will say, my team is responsible. Because of them, I'm able to achieve this project, or we are able to do this project. That is the difference between the leader and leader and manager. The second thing is that, I mean, I would like to give you one example. Have you heard the name of Ratan Tata?
Yeah, ma'am.
The second thing is that leader, I mean, I'm just using this word leader in context of manager. The manager should always able to fulfill their promise. Aapne jo bhi promise kiya hai, at any cost, you have to fulfill your promise. Stop delegating the task. Hamesha delegate mat kijiye task. Kuch task khud kijiye. So that you can lead by example. Aap ek example set kar sake. Kyunki fine, if I can do, I'm the manager. If I can do, you all can do. Because you are better than me. They are appreciating their employees. Agar main kisi ek class ko le sakti hu, let's suppose for 60 minutes. Then I can ask my student, arre beta, agar main 60 minutes le sakti hu, I know. Sneha can take at least for half an hour. Because I know, she has that potential. She can do that. What is that? That you are motivating your employee. That you have the trust on their capabilities. Okay, fine, they can do that. But it should not be like that. Nahi, nahi, mujhe Sneha pe trust hai, Sneha kar sakti hai. So instead of taking lecture, I'm asking every time, Sneha, could you please take my lecture? Sneha, could you please present this topic? No, it should not be there. Sooner or later, Sneha would also start feeling frustrated. She would also feel somewhere that, okay, fine, ma'am is like that. She is running away from her duties. What she is doing, she is only delegating her task. It should not be there. So the manager should be, or the I mean, how can we figure out that the person is a good manager? The one who doesn't believe in delegating the task, the one who sets an example that okay, fine, I will do it first, then you all will do it. The second thing is that he or she should be able to fulfill their promise. For example, when the Ratan Tata promised that they will build the cheapest car, that is Nano, we all know about it. And at that, when they were about to build their plant in West Bengal, they failed a protest over there. I hope you know about it.
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes. Then they shifted their plant from that place to the Gujarat. But they have fulfilled their promise. They have launched that cheapest car, that is Nano, in the market. What is that? That whatever promise the Ratan Tata have made, they have fulfilled that promise. So the in the modern concept, we are looking that type of a manager who is able to fulfill their promise, who always give credit to their team for the success of any project, who is there to take the responsibility. Okay, fine, I'm the one who will take the responsibility, who always lead by example, who always believe in flexible approach. It should not be like that. How you have bypassed the channel, how you have gone to the top management, how you have gone to the CEO. It should not be like that. There should be the flexible approach. Okay, fine. If you want to go, you can. Because of this approach, if we have the horizontal type of organization, the decision would be effective. I mean, unnecessary so much time should not be wasted. Aisa nahi hoga ki hum unnecessary time ko waste karte rahe. Okay, fine. It will go for approval to the middle level manager, then HR manager will see that proposal, then again it will go to the top manager. What is that? Unnecessary, we are wasting our time, and there is a competitor who is sitting there, who is watching our stupidity, and he will instantly tap that market which is not tapped by us, or he or she can tap that untapped market, and we will be busy with this approval system only. So it is the demand of the time, it is the demand of an hour, that we should have a flexible system in an organization. Instead of that bureaucratic system of an organization, we should have a horizontal system of an organization. Are you getting me, Sneha?
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay, so today I will wind up with this concept of management. In the next class, we will discuss about more regarding the nature of management, with more examples, with more live examples related to some corporate sector. Is there any questions related to this concept of management, or whatever we have discussed today?
No, beta.
Okay, now I would okay, thank you, beta. Thank you so much for listening patiently, and you were quite interactive during the session. Thanks for that. Now I would request Rahul sir, if he can
yes, ma'am,
take his
yes,
class,
ma'am,
if possible.
Thank you, ma'am. Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Yeah, Sneha, I am Dr. Rahul Sharma, and I am from School of Management, University of Engineering and Management, Jaipur. As I came to know that you are from commerce background, right? And
yes,
you want to go for BBA.
Yes.
And your purpose of doing the BBA is that you want to focus on some business or something, right?
Yes, sir.
So may I know, do you have any kind of an idea in your mind, or you have a family business which you want to, you know, expand?
No, sir. My father is a businessman, but right, I want to do my own business in future.
Okay. Okay. So may I know what kind of a business your father have?
He has a showroom, tractor showroom.
Okay. Okay. In West Bengal?
Yeah, sir. In West Bengal.
Okay. So, you don't want to go into that particular area. You want your different
own
area.
Business.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
And any kind of an idea you have in your mind that this is what I'm going to do. Obviously, the plan might change according to the time and conditions.
Yes, sir.
But any rough idea, any scratch idea you have in your mind that this is what I'm going to start with?
No, sir. Now I want to know that I want to do international business.
Okay.
So that's all.
international business, which means you want to go for some kind of export import kind of a thing.
Yeah, sir. Export import or international business. I want to set in out of India for business and all.
Okay, so you want to do business, but into the international location. Don't want to go for India. So is there any reason why? I mean, this is quite surprising, not shocking, but surprising that you want to become a business girl or a business woman, but not in India. Why so?
Not in India, not sir. I want to do in international business for few years, so okay. I can get the knowledge and all of that from of their business and all. Then I want shift to India and want to do my business.
Okay, so actually you want to start in India, but your plan is to expand it to the other verticals of the universe. Okay.
Yes.
And right now you have not decided about any particular line or a product you are going to start with.
No, sir.
Right. Okay. So Sneha, since you are just passed out from the school, so and you want to go for the management studies and all. See, the first thing, because right now you will go for the UG in management undergraduate, and then you most probably want to go for some MBA or something. Mm. See, the entire idea of management study is to make you presentable, is to make you able to communicate with people. Now, you might think that, sir, I can communicate, I am communicating with you, so in the same way I can communicate with anyone. For sure. If you can communicate with a single person, you can communicate with other persons also. But the context differs. What I mean by context, that right now, I as a teacher and you as a student are talking with each other. Right now, you don't have any pressure in your mind that if I'm going to say anything wrong in the sense that if I go to give a wrong answer, or if I go to give a different kind of a definition which is not right for something, it will not affect personality. But at the same time, when you have started your business and you are taking the meeting for your employees, do you have a scope of making some mistakes?
No, sir.
You know, you don't have, right?
Yeah.
What is the reason why you don't have a scope for mistake over there?
Because, sir, there I'm a business manager. I think I'm the manager, so.
You are the owner. You are the owner.
So, yeah. For my business, I can't take any risk, or I can't say anything wrong to my employees. So it can affect my business also.
Yeah, it can affect your business. At the same time, whenever the employee is actually into the conversation with the owner or the one who is the reporting manager for them, they have a kind of an expectation from that person. That okay, if that person is of is the owner of this big business, itne bade business ka, if he is the owner, then he must have these qualities. What I'm trying to explain you, that the roles, according to your role, your the people's expectation differs. Like right now, you are into the student life. What we can expect from you is that, okay, she should be in some sort of a discipline. She should have, good manners, or how to talk to the teachers or something. These are the only expectations we have. But when I will be talking to Miss Sneha after 5 or 10 years as a owner of some business, that to the international one, my expectations will not be the same. My expectation would be that she is a kind of a sensible person. She has all the etiquettes that how a business owner will talk to the people. So the entire idea of BBA as a course is not only to give you the literature knowledge. What I mean by literature knowledge,
is that we are going to have a subject of account, we are going to have a subject called financial management. You must have came across these subjects in your 11th and 12th standard also, I know. So you would be having these subjects in your BBA also. The idea is not to give you that only the knowledge which is into the books, because the same subjects can be taught into the BCom also. You know that very well, that the syllabus for BCom and BBA is quite similar. Then why the BBA is into the demand and why people want to go for BBA not BCom? Because BCom is being BBA is being considered to be the professional UG course. It has some professionalism into it. What is that? The professionalism in the sense that if I talk about the curriculum of BBA in UEM Jaipur, we have the summer internships after each almost every semester. Now you must know that what is summer internship. Any idea, Bita?
No, sir.
No idea. See, it's a summer internship is nothing. It is just a kind of a chance which is given to the student to correlate the theoretical knowledge with the practical world. I'm repeating, correlating. You know what is correlation?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, the connecting the theoretical knowledge which you have acquired in your classroom with the practical ones which you are going to test when you are going to work with an organization for a period of 45 days or 30 days or 15 days, depending on the duration of the training. And you actually going to realize that whatever I have studied into the books, all those things are being implemented into the practical world or not. Now, what are the advantages of such programs, such internship programs? The biggest advantage of such internship program is that you actually train yourself to face the reality. What I mean by face the reality, that till the time you are the student, you are sitting into the classroom, you feel some sort of like I'm into the home, and you are pampered by your teachers like their child, or feel secure. But once you start, you know that you just imagine one thing, that you are going to start your first job. And you are into the first day right now, and I as your manager talking to you, you must feel some nervousness in yourself.
Yes.
Yeah. Why? Because right now your mind into that condition that now I'm onto the field. I have done with my training. Now I have to perform. If you don't perform, you will be out of the company. Nobody is going to have you until and unless you perform. You perform according to the expectation level. So my work during this session is to give you the some foundation of mathematics. But since today you are the only one, so we are talking some practical aspects of management. I would like to show you a small video. You know who is Harsha Bogle?
No, sir.
No, do you, have you ever watched some cricket match or something? Any interest?
No, sir.
No. Okay. So let me show you a video of him. Yeah. It is only a 1.5 minute video, I think a 2 minute video. But then we'll talk what it video wants to tell you. Just a second. Beta, are you able to see it?
No, sir.
Not on the screen?
Yeah, now, sir, it is visible.
Now it is visible. Wait a second. I hope it is audible also, beta.
Audible, no sir, but visible only.
You are not getting the voice of this video.
No sir.
Let me try it once again. No voice?
No sir.
Okay, okay, not an issue. Wait. Okay, is it visible to you on the screen?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah. So let us talk about some management lessons from some Bollywood movie. I hope you have watched the movie Chak De India.
Yeah, sir.
Who was the actor in that movie? Can you give me the answer?
No, sir. That.
Oh, Shah Rukh Khan was the actor, I guess, right? Okay, so let us talk something that how the management can be understood from the different movies we came across. The entire idea of sharing all these knowledge related to this is that management is something we can learn from our surroundings. What I mean by surroundings, that whatever happens with you during your 24 hours in a day, something will always give you a managerial skills. You manage yourself from the time you start going to the school by yourself. What I mean by yourself, that in the beginning of your school time, you must know that your parents used to go and they used to pick you up from the school, drop you to the school and pick you up from the school. But is it the same case till the 12th standard?
No, sir.
No, right? Why? Because the time they think that now you can manage yourself, now our daughter can manage herself, they stop going with you. Rather, it's not like that they have you know, stopped taking care of you or something, but they have that sense of understanding in their mind that now she can manage herself. She can go by herself and she can come by herself, not an issue. Sometimes there might be a problem that you missed a bus or something and then they will have to go with you. That's a separate issue. But the time you started managing yourself is the time when you start learning management. Management is nothing but a learning from your surroundings to manage yourself, your life. And this is what the entire idea of any of the management degree. It is of course a degree program, but it is kind of a training which is being given to you to polish yourself, to live into this world, to make yourself a successful person who can have a great life for herself or himself, along with a good life for the family, with a reputation into the society. So there is a dialogue. There was a dialogue in that movie that can you read it into the black font?
Yes, जो नहीं हो सकता वही तो करना है.
Yeah, sounds interesting. And whenever you read this line, you feel a bit of motivation in yourself that जो नहीं हो सकता वही तो करना है.
Yeah.
Since you want to go for the business, you must have some idea. The idea can be like the people. There might be some people who are already into that business. Whenever you think of going into the business field, you will come across something that ye to already ho raha hai. People are doing this already. Then what is the USP? What is unique you are going to come?
एंड दैट यूनिक इज नथिंग बट जो नहीं हो सकता है वही तो करना है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ वी टॉक अबाउट यू नो वॉट इज ओला एंड उबर.
या सर.
या कैन यू आई मीन हाउ लॉन्ग दे आर इन टू द मार्केट? लाइक 5 years, 6 years और 7 years? नॉट मोर देन दैट. 5-7 years. Let us assume that they are only 7 years old. Now, before those 7 years, does anyone thought of something that I will be using a small application, and through that application I'll book a 4-wheeler, which is a car, luxurious car. It will come outside my home. I will sit into it, and I'll reach to my destination. Nobody has thought about it, right? The traditional methods we use, that we used to take a auto rickshaw, we used to take a taxi, but nobody has thought about it that there would be something like an application called as Ola, and we will book the cab. That cab will come to our home. We'll not have to go. For example, in your childhood, whenever you want to go outside your city to, so you'll have to reach to the railway station or a airport. You used to come out of your home along with your baggage and your parents, and you'll have to go to a particular bus stand or a taxi stand to catch a particular vehicle which can drop you to that particular railway station or a airport, right?
Yes, sir.
But is this the same case today? No.
No, sir.
You don't need to bother about it that I have to carry that heavy luggage with me, and then I'll have to go to a particular stand in this in this weather of 40 degree or 41 degree. You don't have to. You just have to log into that application. You have to check that the available cab, and you'll have to click on the confirm booking, and the cab will be there within 5 or 10 minutes at your doorstep. So yeah. this is what jo nahi ho sakta hai wahi to karna hai. People have never thought about it. Second thing, what Ola? Ola has introduced the bikes also. Ola bike, you must have
Ola
heard.
Ola bikes, yes.
Yeah, Ola bikes. What is the concept? The concept is really based on a simple foundation. The foundation is that a person has a 2-wheeler and he want to earn some money. Suppose he is living into a different city, which is not the home city for him. And he is actually studying something. Is preparing for some competitive exam or something. He has a 2-wheeler. So now, since he is living outside his home city, and he must have to pay some fixed expenses. Fixed expenses in the sense the rent for the place he is living in, the food expenses, or the coaching fees or something. So he has that privilege that I have a 2-wheeler. If someone will give me some rupees to drop him to some particular place, and I'll get that money from him. You must have came across that people used to stand onto the roads and asking for a lift to a 2-wheeler. Whenever yes. they find a person going onto an Activa or Hero Honda or whatever it is, they used to ask that person, please, can you drop me to that place? Now that person will take that person and he will drop to that. He will not charge money for that, right? No money will be given to that. That's only social service. But now that social service has converted into a big business model. Now people will book that particular person, and they will ask that person to drop him to a particular place, and according to the time and the kilometer, he will get some money. So out of a small investment of 30,000 or 35,000 into a 2-wheeler, a person has started earning some money for himself. This is what something we can relate to. Jo nahi ho sakta hai, wahi to karna hai. If you would have talked about this particular idea 7-8 years back, people would have laughed on you that this is not the idea. How can you say that the people will start sitting on your 2-wheeler and they will give you money also? No, it is not safe, beta. It is not something. It is not. People will, you know, will pass and smile and a laugh and say, "Ye idea acha nahi hai. This is not the right idea to work with." But no, this is not the thing. Whatever idea. Why I am focusing on this? Because you have a business orientation in your mind. Trust me, everybody has a same amount of brain, but how much you utilize it, that totally depends on you. whatever idea is coming into your mind, Sneha, try to stick to that. Don't ever think that people will laugh on me. People will think that this is not possible, because in today's world, entrepreneurship, right, the business area, only that person will survive who have this attitude called as jo nahi ho sakta hai wahi to karna hai, because then only you can survive. Why you will survive by following this particular line? Because you are entering into a field where nobody else is there, so there is no competition. You have the first mover advantage. You must have heard this particular line, first mover advantage.
Yes, sir.
So first mover advantage is that nobody is there to compete with you. And till the time there will be a competitor into that particular area, you would have passed to a particular stage of business where nobody can even touch to you. People will start after 5 years, but within these 5 years, you will reach to a particular position, which is nothing less than a leading position, the commanding position into the area. So this is what the idea, jo nahi ho sakta hai, wahi to karna hai. Now, how we can relate it with the movie, that we should try to make difference. 16 girls, different states, different backgrounds, different skill set, but one dream, winning. In that movie, if you can recall, there were girls, players from different states. Someone from Punjab, someone from Haryana, someone from Delhi. There were different people all around, right?
Yes, sir.
So what was the difference? The difference was that the people would actually had a single dream, and that dream is nothing but winning for the country, winning for self. Let's move on to the second one. A common goal. What do we mean by common goal? That all functions must work together towards an objective, creation of success through a die-hard attitude, teamwork, high energy, and extreme passion for work among their team. Beta, if you want to go for a business, you should have all these skills in yourself. That you should have a particular objective for which you, by yourself, working with die-hard attitude. What do you mean by die-hard attitude? Is that I will have to do it for my survival. If you have that particular thing in your mind, that this business will have to flourish, I have to make this business flourish, otherwise I will be finished. There is no use studying or something and all. If you have that attitude in your mind, trust me, you will succeed in your business. Because you have a broad idea in your mind that, sir, I don't want to limit myself to India. I want to expand my business into the international places. So for that particular thing, you should have a strong desire that, yes, I want to do it and I will do it. Whatever the situations will come in front of me, I will actually achieve it. See, you must have heard a line called as, don't be the victim of circumstances, be the master of circumstances.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what does it mean? What does it mean?
That we don't want to be the victim or what's happening, we don't want to adopt that. We have to change.
Yeah, exactly. See, let me give a small example to you. You have got to give a particular presentation to your employees. I'm just into that assumption that you have started your business and right now you are doing that business from last 5 years. So right now, today, you have to give a presentation to your clients who can be your investors into the future projects. So you have to give a presentation tomorrow. You have prepared that total presentation and you have rehearsed that presentation thoroughly, and now tomorrow is the morning. Now, tomorrow morning, you are going to the office. You have started setting up your projector and computer and whatever it is. Suddenly, your presentation is being deleted from the system. You have no presentation in your laptop, which you have prepared from last 2-3 days. You have rehearsed last night a lot to impress your financier, impress your investors. Now,
give me an answer. What will you do in this situation?
Sir, I will give thoroughly without presentation. I will give oral.
This is what the thing. You have not chosen the way to become the victim of circumstances. You have chosen the second way, which is be the master of circumstances. This is what total idea, and this is what the entire attitude of a businessman. Don't become the victim of circumstances. Become the master of circumstances is the entire idea. So you had that particular thing in your mind that if today I'll not give the presentation, if I'll give them a reason that, sir, I have, I'm really sorry, I have prepared it, but somehow due to some technical errors, I have missed it. So the thing is that you can say this and the investor will say, okay, not an issue. They will give you some sugar-coated sympathy that, okay, but do you think they will invest in your business? They will give you money?
No, sir.
No. Why? Because you actually, I have no idea what you have done yesterday till the time I see that presentation. So right now you have no presentation with yourself. So I'll have a perception that she has not prepared at all. So why would I invest for a person who is not that sincere for a particular opportunity he or she is getting to get a good amount, a handsome investment for her business, because of which her business can, you know, can expand its net worth, expand its market share. So if you are not serious, let it be. Let's find someone else who is serious for the opportunity. So you should have a strong desire for a common goal. You should have a particular attitude towards it that, yes, I will have to do it. Otherwise, I'll be finished from the market. We should try to make difference. And in the context of that particular movie, 16 girls, different states, different backgrounds, different skills, set. All of those 16 girls had a different background in terms of their states. They had a different skill set. Someone was good in something, someone was good in something. But what actually connected them together as a team is one dream that we will have to bring the World Cup back. We'll have to bring the World Cup back to India. And this is what you must have came across this full form of TEAM.
Team. Yes, sir.
Together, everyone achieves more. Nowadays, since again, I'm referring your particular objective that you want to go for a business. In business, so many times you have to work under a team. You have to develop a team. No matter, you would be the captain of that team. You would be the founder of that team. But you will have to work under a team. Because nobody can fight a single battle, if I can fight a single war alone, nobody. You will have to have a team which can support you, a team in which the members from different skill sets would be there. So you should believe in working in team, and you should have that attitude that, yes, I will adjust into a team, and you should be the key part of that team. Because if you don't become the key part of that team, the team will lose you, or either you will lose that team. Because you'll have to show your worth, that why I am the owner of this team, why I am the captain of this team. Because the time your team realizes we are under a big leadership, they will stay with you. Now, a leader who made them realize their own potential. See, there is a difference between a boss and a leader. You should always work upon becoming a leader, not a boss. Boss can be anyone. It is quite easy to become boss. If you have money, you have a business, you are at a position and you will say, I am the boss. I'll say whatever I'll say and you'll have to do it. Otherwise, you can leave my company. You cannot survive into the market with this attitude. You should have a leadership skill. Because a leader is one who made them realize their own potential. You are the one who will actually motivate your employees that you can do it. You have that skill. Try. Impossible is nothing. So you should have that leadership skill in yourself, which can motivate your team, which can motivate your fellow members into the business. The right attitude. It is very important to possess right attitude. A positive body language can make a huge difference. Now, let me ask you a question. That Sneha, do you think that body language actually have some role in your presentation?
Yeah, sir. If we are not impressive, then I don't think it work.
How body language differs? Can you give some example from your experience or from your perception that this is what the difference, what body language can make?
If we have a presentation and all, but we are not good enough to explain that through our body language or through our vocabulary, so I don't think it will work, or the employees, the client can't understand.
What happens, that's suppose right now I am giving you this presentation and I'm speaking like right attitude, it is very important, you can think my voice is something like that, I'm just taking it as my liability, okay, pata nahi kahan phas gaya, bas patapat khatam karu aur jau. This is not the right attitude. My voice should be like that, I am actually interested to deliver this presentation to you, I am actually interested to talk to you on something which is connecting Chak De India as a movie with the management lessons we can learn from it. So if I am not enthusiastic, if I am not energetic to express myself to you, do you think you will take interest in this? Because this is something which I you must have that thing in your mind that sir, if I go and search the Google, I would have find that something like this. Yes.
Yeah.
In today's area of internet, nothing is hidden to anyone. It is only required that you have to go to the Google, you have to write that I want to search this and you will get it. So what is the difference? The difference is that I have brought it for you just to express these things, that this is the thing we can learn from this small movie called as Chak De India. This is the difference. The difference is my interest, my zeal to talk to you, to deliver what I want to explain you, that we can learn management from the things around us. Right, so positive attitude along with positive body language can make a huge difference. Power of expectations, because he means the Kabir Khan, the coach in that movie, he believes that it is not that we cannot win, it's just that we have never believed that we can. Can you read this line better? Because
yes, sir. Because he believes that it is not that we cannot win; it's just that we have never believed that we can.
Can you understand the difference?
Yes, sir.
Between the two lines, what is the difference?
He believes that he is not that we cannot win. He believes that it is not that he can't win the match or thank the match, but he never believed that he can win.
The thing is that it is not like for example, let us connect it with you again. You want to go for a business, but the thinking matters. One thing is that it is not like that you cannot do this business. The only difference is that you have never thought that you can. That means you have thought that there are so many competitors into this field. People are already running their business into this area. Why should I enter? Now, if this is the thing, then there is no option to do the business into the regular areas. Nobody can come. See, for example, you must have heard about Zomato.
Yes, sir.
And you must have heard about Swiggy.
Yes, sir.
Which app came first, Zomato or Swiggy?
Zomato,
right? Zomato was already into the market, and so many years it was into the market. But then, what makes forced the owner of Swiggy, the founder of Swiggy, to come into this area? He must have thought that Zomato is already the leader and it has captured the market. Why should I go? Why should I enter into this area? If this was the thought process of founder of Swiggy, he would not come into this area, and if he would not came into this area, he would not have realized that I can give a tough competition to someone who is already established into the area. You know that Swiggy has given a tough competition to Zomato. In general observations, before the introduction of Swiggy, you would not have seen the delivery boys of Zomato so frequently into your area. But the time when Swiggy came into the market, you have started observing that the people, the delivery boys from Zomato, are also into the market. This is what the difference. The difference is that we should think that we can, instead of thinking that we cannot. We should have that particular expectations with ourselves that yes, I will do it. I will do the same thing, but in a different way. I will do the same thing, but in a different way. Got it, beta?
Yes, sir.
Okay. True meaning of success. Success does not mean the absence of failure. Very good line. Can you read it?
Yeah, sir.
Yeah. Success does not
mean the absence of failure. It is about winning the war and not ever battle.
Yeah. A very good example is written into the second point, that it is about winning the war, not every battle. What does it mean? Let me give you an example. Have you heard about Mahabharat? Have you seen that Mahabharat?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you have that basic idea that what was the entire story of Mahabharat, who fought against whom. You have that small idea.
Yes,
so
sir, little.
So that war was was there for 17-18 days, right?
Yes.
It was not like that on every day. Pandavas won. On some day it was Kauravas who were leading. It was some day when Pandavas were leading. But what made the difference? The difference is that the entire idea of Pandavas was to win this war. It is not that we will win every day. It is not that every day will be your day. There must be some day. There might be some day which truly is not your day. You will feel frustrated. You will feel demotivated that no, this is everything is finished and nothing. See, everybody actually breaks down. Everybody has some setbacks in life, but it doesn't matter. What matters is that how many times you will stand up and fight back. How many times you stand up and fight back. If your life don't have any problem, trust me, you are not living a worthy life. Because problems are actually which gives you an opportunity to realize your true potential. Agree with me or not?
Yeah, sir.
Because if the problems are not there, you will not realize that what I can do. Because till the time you will push yourself to fight, you will not realize that I have this power. So this is what the actual meaning of success. You should always focus on winning the war instead of winning every battle. Strategize your move and know what you want to achieve. Harnessing the right talent for the right job. Again, as a owner of your business, you should always focus that this is the particular task which needs to be done. Then you should have the capability to identify the right people for that particular job. If you will give a particular job to a person who is not capable of doing that particular job, you will miss the market. You have done the wrong decision of giving that particular job to that person. So you should be focused on finding the right person for that. Like the story of Kabir Khan and his 16 girls, all organization and its employees should work towards a common vision and be a part of a team that believes in creating a world-class organization. This is actually the management connection with that movie. That just like that person, if you can recall that movie, for the initial part of the movie, he was struggling to join all those girls together as a team. Every girl was thinking that I am the best, I am the best, I am the best, and nobody want to work in a team. So what he did, what Kabir Khan did, he actually tried his level best to make them as a team, to join them as a team. Because when you are actually working as a team, then you will realize that yes, now we can achieve this objective. If a player is playing for himself or herself, they will not be able to reach to the particular particular destination, that is the success of the business. And the last point, don't just build an organization. Build cross-functional and multi-skilled teams to achieve your dream. You should always work in finding a team which is from the different areas, people who are from different functional areas, people who are from different skills, people who are from different specialization, because diversification is the key. If you have 2,000 rupees to invest, you should not invest those 2,000 rupees into the shares of one company or into the one investment option. You should always divide that 2,000 rupees into the 500, into the group of four, 500 rupees each, and invest those 500 into the four different areas. So that if the one area has collapsed, you have the chance to gain from other areas, right? So you should have the principle of diversification with yourself. Whenever you are going to make a team, whenever you are going to come up with a team. So this is what I wanted to actually share. I really appreciated if that video would have worked, but the sound was not coming. So not an issue. We will have that video some other day. So this is what the entire idea, Sneha. You have taken this session, both the sessions, quite attentively. I really must thank you for that. And we will really looking forward to have a journey of 3 years at least for the BBA, and then probably the 2 years for the MBA in times to come. So any question you have in your mind, you can ask better.
No, sir. No, sir.
No question at all?
No, sir.
Okay. So the only thing I request you is that please be regular into the session. These are only once in a week. That is on Friday. From 11 a.m. Try to be regular, because each and every day we'll be having some different kind of knowledge sharing. Please don't consider it as a lecture that they have started teaching me. We are not here to teach you. We are just here to give you an orientation that this is what you should do and this is what you should not do. So this is what the only idea of these sessions. We are into the discussion mode rather than into a lecture mode. So we'll always welcome you and your suggestions and your participation into whatever we are delivering. So in the next class, in the next session, we will we'll be waiting for you, and try to be regular. And whenever you have any question, you can ask it. Not an issue.
Thank you so much, sir.
Right. Okay. So yeah. Thanks for the day. We'll see you on next Friday. All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sneha. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am.